Welcome back, Legion. All right, we're here on some unspecified day. I don't know what day it is. I'm still pretty hyped and jacked. I just did the Suicide Squad trailer, and I'm still pretty hyped about that because it was just awesome. But this is like Imperium trailer featuring Daniel Radcliffe. Okay. When he started doing like performance art or Broadway type stuff, theater, and he was doing like nakedness. I was like, eh, okay. I mean, I was never a fan of Harry Potter as like the as not the movies, but him specifically. But then I was like, eh. And then he was in like Sin City, and he was an awesome character in Sin City. Now he's gonna be in Now You See Me 2. I think Radcliffe is back on the rise, man. He's been away. He's really kind of he did. I think he did it right, guys. I think Daniel Radcliffe did it right. He was really young. He made a fuck ton of money. And instead of being played out like a child star usually does, he was like, well, I'm gonna go do some stuff I like to do. And I'm gonna go do that. I'm gonna go do some theater. He's English. Maybe that's just in his blood. Who knows? But he stayed away from movies. He didn't get all that. He didn't do what like Bieber did. Bieber did a hard transition from being the kid singer, which also can contribute to, you can compare Bieber to like a Disney star almost, or a Nickelodeon kid. Maybe, no, Disney's more important because look at all the people that came from Disney. But he was young and had that audience, and he had a huge following as if he was on one of those channels. And then he went straight into being like the punk kind of rebellious whatever phase, to kind of transition into being the adult and doing more adult things. And it was a hard rookie. Rookie? Rookie? The fuck did I just say? Rookie? What? Rocky. Rocky transitions to whatever. Daniel decided to just stay away and not oversaturate the market with his success as playing Harry Potter. And I think that's awesome. Shows restraint and a desire to do something more than just be famous. So with that being said, I'm actually looking forward to seeing what this trailer is all about because I just gave myself some newfound respect for Daniel Radcliffe. Never thought I'd have it. For anybody that has honestly stayed for 2 minutes and 37, 38, 39 seconds, 2 minutes and 30, 41, 42 seconds, I really appreciate you checking this out. I do. For like the two people that are gonna watch this, thank you. Lionsgate, premiere! Grindstone.
You see the best
swastikas
reputation we have here?
right there.
We could always use a man like you, Nathan.
Oh shit, okay. He
Educated
doesn't fit the
or veteran,
skinhead type,
clean
but
record.
maybe that's why.
So what's the overall objective here?
He's a plant.
This is revolutionary activity we're talking about here.
Oh shit. Oh, okay, man. Inspired by real events.
Get in there and make a difference.
We are a thinking man's soldiers. First here, and then here.
We know where you live.
I don't have the skills for this. I can't even defend myself.
You do have the skills.
This is gonna be
to
fucking intense.
We see what we want to see. But just because you're not looking at something,
oh shit.
Get your hands off me.
Doesn't mean it's not there.
You okay there, Nate? Look a little off.
Wow, dude. This is gonna be awesome.
They're coming. An event.
Holy shit.
People up.
Hey, it's the true blood guy.
Plot.
This morning in
Dude.
America, and there's a new day coming.
Are you a cop?
These guys are fanatics. They will not be taken alive.
For evil
Hell yeah.
to triumph.
Oh shit.
It only takes good men.
Oh!
To do nothing.
Oh, Imperium.
Let me ask you something, Nathan. What's your opinion on infiltration?
Do you suspect someone?
It's just, you know, it's like they say at these rallies. You look to the left, look to the right. You know, one of these people is a snitch.
Oh shit, man. Oh, shit. Wow. I didn't really want to talk or do anything. I just wanted to watch that. No joke. There's, I can kind of see how I might be a little bit hypocritical. I'm going to call myself out real quick because I've noticed maybe I'm not the most accepting, but I am certainly not a racist person or a prejudiced person. But I feel when people do videos, movies, or content in any capacity that is like pro the Caitlyn Jenner thing, the Epic Rap Battles, or the Douglas thing in Epic Rap Battles, or movies or whatever that's like showing this class, I always get like, I stand off from those, I think because we're, in this right here, we are seeing white power. And we are seeing neo-Nazis in America right now. That's what this is about, at first look. What they are showing is the flaw and the evil that these people represent. Not as white people, as human beings. When anybody ever does anything for the other races in the world, it's all about them being the victims or never triumphing. I forgot who it was. I believe it was Ice Cube's son that said that he wasn't cool with the Roots being remade because, excuse me, because it wasn't about, he said, I'm tired of the struggle. We have plenty of success stories out there. Let's do those. And yeah, that's it. I think people are tired of seeing other people say, we're the victim or we're this. And, you know, I think that kind of talk needs to go away. In general, whether it's the racism against black people or Asian people or Native Americans or whoever. I think people don't give them the respect because a lot of what it is saying, hey, this is what's happening to us. Instead of, hey, these are the changes that are going to be made. And this right here is a good example. This is not saying white people are prosecuted or white people are being made out to be this or that. This is saying, hey, these people are the problem. There's no victims here, at least in that trailer. There's nothing like that. No one's saying that this is, you know, a lot. I think that a lot of these things that showcase other races are to say they're justifications to why some people are bad in their community and some aren't. To try to say, this is what happened 100 years ago. This is why convenience stores or people are being robbed. And I think that's how some people may take those situations. I personally just look at things how they are in the here and the present. I don't gauge people in the past or the, you know, what's going to happen in the future, what's going on right now. If you're a bad person now, you're a bad person in general. If you're somebody that's not that person, cool on you, man. It doesn't matter what skin color or what race you are, I guess. That's the same thing. What religion you decide to believe in. I have no problem with Muslim people. I think that, like, as far as the men of that whatever go, cool, man, you work hard. I think Hispanic men and women and all that work hard. But I think Middle Eastern women are attractive as well. And I don't... And I say that because there was this, I believe, a senator. I can't remember who he was. Some people may remember. I should remember his name, but I can't. In New York, he's a Jewish man, I believe, married to a Muslim woman or something like that, Palestinian or something along those lines, something that's just not the typical white Jew. And people are saying he's a betrayer. They've said that he betrayed his people because he married that woman. I was like, wow, like, that's incredible. I find women of all kinds of nationalities or place in the world attractive. It's whatever it is that I find attractive. And it doesn't matter what skin color you are. It's just if that woman's attractive, she's attractive. If that dude works hard, he works hard. That's just kind of how things are, right? That's just how things should be. And so I think that a lot of movies are specifically made to make certain groups look like they've been the victim. When I think the people at large aren't the victims anymore. I think they've moved on and they're going forward. But yet people making... whether it's the Roots or whatever it is, nowadays, which is saying, look how hard it was back then. And what's really the message behind that movie and why is it being remade? To bring more awareness to something that happened a long time ago? Or are you trying to make some kind of connection to what's going on now and then? I, I mean, I look at every community as just, every community has its problems, man. And it's never going to be fixed right away. And it won't be fixed in our lifetimes. I doubt it. All you got to do is just keep moving forward. When you don't let things bother you, when you keep moving, and you just accept what's going on and you just brush it aside, because in life you can just do that. You can accept the horribleness that is the world and you can just say, but I'm going this way later. You can go do your bad stuff over there because you can't change it. You can't stop it. All you got to do is just, when you come to together as a group and then accept help or accept friendship from another group, I mean, what's going to stop you? The guy that was in Dallas, man, I think for a lot of ignorant people that aren't in that community, I think a lot of ignorant people are going to justify hating on this specific group because of that one man's actions. And people that aren't dumb will understand that that dude was just, had more problems than racial tension. And the military probably didn't agree with him. And I'm going to leave it right there. I took it kind of serious. It's 11 minutes. I'm so sorry for that. But I had some stuff to say. I've said some stuff before. People get on me. I turned the Kylie Jenner epic rap battles into something like this. And people really got on my case. Some woman. And I don't really care. Sorry. If I got something to say, man, this is my channel. I'm going to say it. If you don't like it, you can move on. It's fine. I appreciate you stopping by and giving me the chance to entertain you. But this movie is going to be pretty insane, and it's going to be showcasing just, I don't know. I can't make one specific point. It's just going to show everything, I hope. And I hope it's just going to be, because this kind of stuff interests me a lot. This kind of world and people doing stuff like this. I want to know, I'm interested in why people do stuff. I'm going to get out of here. Thanks for watching. Thanks for hanging out. If you like the video, you like the content, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, share it, do all that good stuff if you don't mind. Understandable. If not, I'll see you guys next time. Later.